Hi everybody, today is February 28th, 2013. Student protester in Venezuela vows to continue anti-government rallies as President Hugo Chavez recovers in a Havana hospital. Student protesters in Venezuela said they will not recognize the new government. Days after having been brutally beaten up by the Chavez regime agents, Lawrence Sala explained why Venezuelan youths have no other option but to take to the streets to demand the restoration of the Constitution, even when they are knowingly risking their lives. RT has a bunch of images. Says students have a chain protest. And there's a whole bunch of images here. Information you'll hear on the news. The images that they're showing doesn't seem to be a lot of demonstrators, but I think that's probably why they show these images. Try and make it look like it's just a small group of individuals. We've had 14 years of the same, and every time our future gets more blurry, we cannot allow them to continue to make fun of us, said Sally in an interview via Skype, during which he showed great difficulty speaking. His face looked deformed, his lips swollen. The blows to his face had weakened his upper gum so much that he felt pain with every word. Even so, Sally said that he and his comrades are ready to continue to protest the installation of a illegitimate regime in Venezuela. We're getting ready to strengthen the protests even more. We're getting ready to go national. The government knows this, which is why it is acting the way it is, he said. There are hundreds of youths like Sally who have initiated journeys of protest to express their discontent over the installation of a Chavez government, not headed by President Hugo Chavez, which is seen by the opposition as an aberration of the country's laws orchestrated from Havana. The almost daily demonstrations by students of some of the main schools in the country seek to alert the international community of the illegitimacy of the government's president by Vice President Nicolas Maduro on behalf of Chavez, whose real medical condition is unknown to Venezuelans. Representatives of the University of Carabobo expressed their solidarity Wednesday with the hunger strike initiated by two young students before the building that houses the Organization of American States demanding the appointment of an independent medical board to travel to Cuba and evaluate the health conditions of the president. That demonstration was going on while another group of students of the Central University of Venezuela gathered before the Supreme Court to protest the court's blessing of the regime headed by Maduro. That ruling is nothing more than legitimizing a de facto government, said the student Francisco Matthews. Not having a president to take oath, we find ourselves with a de facto government that today is already naming officials. Chavez, who suffers from aggressive cancer, traveled to Havana on December 9th to have new surgery, and he has not been seen in public since then. The Venezuelan government insists that the president is in full process of recovery, though a series of media versions say that Chavez faces a very delicate medical situation and that his cancer is in the terminal stage. The beginning of a new Chavez term, inaugurated last Thursday, in a strange ceremony in which Maduro took the oath of hundreds of Chavez followers, is questioned by some of the main leaders of the opposition, who reject the Supreme Court's ruling ratifying the measure. The ruling of the court, which is considered by the opposition as an apex of the Chavez regime, is one of the central issues of the students protesting during the last 2 days. Yet the demonstrations are being brutally repressed by law enforcement agents. About 11 students who took part in the protests at the University of Addis, ULA, at the end of last week were wounded after a National Guard agent shot them with pellets. And there's two more pages. I'll give you a link if you want to read more. All right, bookmark my site. I'll keep everyone up to date. Please stay safe, and I'll talk to you later. God bless you all. Bye.